BricsCAD makes 3D surfaces using many of the same commands it uses to create 3D solids. The Extrude command is the most fundamental command for converting 2D entities, also known as sketches, into 3D models. So I'm going to type the Extrude command at the command prompt, and then notice that there is a mode option. Mode lets you determine whether the result is a solid or a surface. I'm going to type SU for surface, select the circle, press enter, and specify a height of, say, 2. So there we have a surface, and you can tell it's a surface because it's open at either end. Surfaces are not watertight. This is different than a 3D solid. This one's extruded from the same circle, but it's watertight. There is no holes in it. A second way to draw a surface is to start with an open sketch, such as this elliptical arc here. Anything that's open will extrude automatically as a surface. So I'm going to start with the extrude command again, selected it, give it a height of 2, and there it is. Now, if we were to use the command to insist that BricsCAD make a solid out of this open sketch, it would refuse. The DM extrude command, which you find here on the ribbon in the surface tab, is for dynamically creating extrusions. So let me start the command, choose this elliptical arc, and then as I move my cursor back and forth, it dynamically changes in size. On the command prompt, you can see a bunch of options. For example, B for both sides extrudes to both sides of the initial arc. Taper angle makes it go in. Or if we set a negative taper angle, it then tapers outwards. If you want to specify the height, you can enter a value, or else turn on dynamic input and enter the value immediately at the cursor. The revolve command rotates a sketch around an axis to create a three-dimensional surface. So here I've drawn a profile using a polyline, and then this center line here will be the axis about which it's rotated. Now I'm going to just make a couple of changes before we start. Change the viewpoint and bring this down into the corner here so we can see what's going on. So up here on the ribbon, I'll choose Revolve, and because it's in the Surface tab, BricsCAD automatically switches the mode to Surface. I'm prompted to select Entities, so I select the profile, press Enter to continue, ask me to select an entity that defines the axis, I pick that center line, and now BricsCAD gives you a preview of what the three-dimensional surface looks like. And as I move the cursor around, I'm specifying the angle, so if I want a full one, or a partial revolve. So I think I'll do 250 degrees, and there it is. Let's look at it around using orbit mode, and you can see that it's definitely hollow. It's a surface. One of the most interesting of BricsCAD's commands working with surfaces is the loft command, which is often a precursor to doing things like airplane wings and air conditioning ducting. I'm going to show you how to do a heating duct transition from square to round using the loft command. Here I've drawn a square using the rectangle command. Now I'm going to precisely center a circle on it. I'm going to use the 2P, the 2 points option, and then use midpoint entity snap to grab the middle of here and the middle of here. Now I've got the circle precisely centered, but they're both at the same elevation. So let me grab the circle, go into the properties, and change the Z to say 24 inches. We can see the circle and the square at different elevations. Let me go to the Surfaces tab, choose Loft, and it asks me to select the entity. So I'll select the square and the circle. Press Enter to continue, ignore the options, and then let's switch the visual style to my favorite, shades of gray, which lets you get a better idea of what it looks like. Here's another example of loft. I've drawn three splines, this one at zero elevation, this one at 9 inches elevation, and this one at 1.5 feet elevation. So let me start the loft command, pick the three splines, and then press enter. And when I orbit, we can see we have a pretty interesting shape. Guides are like paths for lofts, and so I'll show you how to create a loft along the edge of a 3D solid. Here I have a 3D solid box, and I've curved the one side of it using the fillet command. To do this drawing, we need to have the dynamic UCS turned on, which is down here, and I've also turned on the snap and grid to be able to visualize things. The dynamic UCS helps you reorientate the drawing plane to match the faces of the solid. Start the circle command, and then I move the cursor onto this face, which I want to match the drawing plane. Tap the shift key. The face gets darker. BricsCAD alerts you that indeed it is locked to the drawing plane for the duration of the command. I'm going to enter in 2P to draw the two-point circle. First point is here, and the second point is here. The size of the circle for this exercise is not critical, it's just to be able to draw it in that orientation. Now I'm going to change the viewpoint so I can see the other face. Start the rectangle command. Tap the shift key again. And we'll put the first point here. And we'll put another point up here to draw the rectangle. Choose the loft command. Here's the first cross section. Second cross section, and notice that it goes across straight. To curve it around the edge of the solid, I'm going to enter in G for guides, and then it prompts me for a guide curve, and I'll choose this edge along here, and there you can see that the loft now curves along the edge. Let's do an orbit so we can look at it from various sides.